Hello everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Advance Wars Reboot Camp. Last time, we're in hot pursuit of Sturm, but now it's the final front. We should not forget either.
Let's soar.
Now, Eagle. Colin. And Andy.
Oh, yeah.
Let's roll. Final front. And
foolish worms, I've seen this strategy before, and the strategy you're thinking of replacing it with, and the replacement for that.
That is a creepy line to be voiced.
I am warfare incarnate. The best you can do is choose a maneuver that might briefly postpone your defeat.
And indeed, the death ray. The good news is that it only fires 3 tiles long. That's your good news. The bad news is we have to deal with 2 black cannons, and this is the harder version of this map. There's missile cells at the back, but I've never been able to reach them. So, don't rely on them. The missiles in the back, however, are a different story. So, how this map's going to work is that we're going to be dealing with mainly a force coming out here. If we can break into here, and we get 1 bomber in, we're done. We've won. The problem is getting a bomber past these. because we need to blow both of these up first, because there's no way we're making a bomber pass that. Colin, I brought Colin along because his units are cheaper, so I can produce them faster. He's going to be effectively the unit producing machine. Where if we're needing some powerful units, we're pulling from Colin. Sorry. Oh, sorry. The reason why I didn't put him in the middle is because we want his most powerful units to not be damaged. And we can't do that if he's in the middle. Now, Andy. Andy's here to help us push. It'll be a bit before Andy's able to aid us properly. But once he's able to reach this base, and help us push and break this black cannon, we're safe. Yeah, for a while we won't be actually pulling out much units, if any at all. But every seventh day, we do have something else to contend with. Day 2. Of course, if we can, the sooner we can sneak in a bomber, the better. Because the later the map goes on, the harder it is for us to do. Bomber. Okay. Anti-air infantry. Like I said, Colin is going to be our really master of powerful vehicles. Of course, we can get Andy to get a bomber, we can break through. Okay, now we push forward. Okay, bring a bomber. Just make sure to count when it's day 7, don't build any units. It's a waste. And build a battle copter.
Okay. Ugh.
The site's convening a bit of help. Off-road bomber over there. Oh, bring in more units. Please set the missile target. And turn. Throw in the bomber. We need as much power to push through. Ugh. You know what? Okay, this is going to become a bit stressful. We're barely able to take anything down by the vault. Bring in missile. Why would you buy him? Do it again. Okay, wait. Okay, so I can either place it there just so I can be like, okay, I can either sail by. Okay, we should be fine for one more day. However, once it reaches day 23, we need to avoid pull a helicopter, not a helicopter, a bomber. Liking this. Oh, before I forget. Don't underestimate me. I think Gold Rush is the second reason. Alright. So dopey and dumb. It's great because of it. Drop. Okay, weaken them. Think. Yeah, the right side, the left side might need it, but also the middle is also quite in need. All right. We weakened this unit down to one. Alright. Oh no, it isn't. Oh no, it's not. No, it is! Okay. Ugh, that's disgusting. Ugh. The good news so far is that he hasn't really built anti-air in the center. Okay, I can get on to here. Okay, I can sneak by. And I didn't move. That's on me. Go away, anti-air. Missiles coming closer. No, I don't want to. I'm an idiot. Blast 20. Okay, I need to. Don't want to buy too much, but I do need some air units soon again. By blowing up one side to get to the other is a good idea. Oh my god. Okay. So I can fire there. I can weaken the new tank. This is not good. Oh hey! Boom. Alright, I can't pick those units, they're not mine. I need to take out that plane, the bomber. Not plane. Planes are different. Slowly building. Drop bombs. I did it again! I keep getting a heavy units down there. And meteor strike comes. It's gonna... Oh! He had a new quote! I did not know! Nice though. Wait! What?! Meteor strike must be glitched, because there's or they must have changed it heavily, because there's no way that's more expensive, or got more HP than anything else. And if you can direct it anywhere, that's more scary. But I'm also more upset by that because it's like, what? I'm not allowed to manipulate, because why? Ugh. Literally, all those orange star units there. Before I go do that, just remembered. Okay. They're blocking the way. You've got to be kidding me. I literally can't do anything because of this. You have got to be kidding me. Sorry for sounding kind of annoyed. Because, being real. It's already bad enough we have to deal with a really bulky Sturm.
Well, there goes my plan. Because Colin was partly a distraction, partly there just... give me beefy units. Alright, didn't move you. Oh well. Doesn't matter now. Let's march onward. Alright, I hate doing this again, because it's like... ugh. Oh yes, clearly, you're clearly so much better. Bullshit. I fucking hate this. Sorry. God, I hate when games do this. But again, it's because it might just be that I'm used to how it was, and it's changed, is the thing. Well, I'm trying to give the game a benefit of the doubt. God, does it feel like it's specifically targeting stuff. So... this is going to make everything so much longer. Blast them to pieces and don't let their anti-air units live. Treat with that. Treat with that too. Medium tank. Move. Deep breaths in and out.
What? Okay. That's just me being stupid, but God, I cannot help feel targeted. I need to send one up there, but there's just not enough time. It's not even in the middle, so I can probably make a push. I'm upset that I can't get away. Getting to repair that. Might as well just destroy you too. Goodbye, don't come back. Now let's see if I can try and delay you a few turns at most. If I can delay you completely, that'd be great. Sorry if I'm saying a lot, but I love this game. God. It sometimes just really get to me. Especially since we're running low on time. And I've always managed to get pretty low on time in this half time. But not this bad. Ugh. And they're gonna pop. They're gonna pop their ability again, and there's just. Ugh. I hate this. This is not fun to deal with. If Meteor Strike ends up striking one of my bombers, specifically one of Eagle's bombers, I should clarify, I'm going to be mad because it does mean that they changed how Meteor Strike works, and I don't think I like it. But compared
Probably it's fine. But I'm not someone who likes, who thinks competitive should be the focus of games. Like, yeah, if you can play the game, unless the game is built around being competitive, a game should be fun first and foremost. Which is why I'm not a big fan of the Advance Wars competitive scene, because it's just... Sorry to anyone who does play the competitive scene, but the competitive scene is just not friendly. It's not really friendly-ish. Well, it is friendly, is in terms of the people themselves. But I mean more of, it's a case of, you're not going to have fun unless you really competitive. And it's like, is that good design if you got two, if you have to have your game, your remake of a game be focused on the competitive scene? I'm going to scream, because part of this is my fault 100% in the case of, oh my god, it's because of my bombers in the way. But then there's stuff, but I'm rambling. You guys probably don't like to hear me ramble, so I'm going to just shut. Thank you. Okay, let's see where this lightning strike goes. Now, where is it going to go? Meteor strike. I'm not sure if that actually was rigged or not, because it seems is the thing. But because I know we as humans like to see patterns, I also know about that this is potentially just me seeing things. Oh my god, you really want to beat this annoying game. Screw off. Like, seriously, screw off. I can't even get in here. Thanks. Thanks for effectively screwing me. Okay, I should be able to stop it at least. At this point, I might as well just throw bombers out and hope I can get one by. Because, like, seriously, I'm not getting anywhere like this now. Because The worst part is, I'm not even mad at the how the map is, because it's a well-designed map. Just everything else surrounding it is not great. And I get that this is also a problem of having an AI that's smarter than what it could do originally. Because that's part of the problem, the fact that AI is indeed smarter. And that was something you couldn't really factor in. But that's kind of why you have stuff like roulette AIs, which, for those of you who don't know, it's literally a roulette of set AIs a character can have, and whichever AI it lands on controls them for X amount of time or a whole match. Command & Conquer, I believe, had that for some of their campaign maps, which made some of them really interesting, but it also backfired in some ways. At least I can hyper upgrade, which is something I can at least take solace in. The problem is, actually, okay, it's not going to be the biggest. Explosion, but hey, I'm not trying to make the biggest splash. I'm trying to at least eliminate him. Okay, don't let them progress. Bomber. You know what? I'm gonna just try and charge. Let's move. Oh, it's gonna hit one of them. I need to make a push. I need to make a push with colon. Or at least make it seem like I'm pushing. Oh, this is not good, come on. Okay. I'm going to see if that helps. Actually, no. That's not bad. I can actually see how far I can get with those two. I just need to hold on for two turns. That's fine. He didn't build a bomber. Well, he did build a bomber. But he didn't build... Okay. Slot you two in. Bomber. Okay. I think thanks to this, I might be able to pull out from under the grave. Okay. Okay, I'm going to roll through. I don't have room to get there yet. As long as it doesn't pull an anti-air out of nowhere, I should be fine. It can pull on the last turn, I'm about to get there. But as long as it doesn't pull one out right before. Okay, come on. Because if he does, I'll need to pull a lightning strike. Wait, did he just pull missiles? If he pulled up missiles, that was stupid of him. He pulled a missile. Why? I want this. And I can even go over here, just in case I miscounted when the missile comes out. I don't think I did, though, so... Victory. Need to make sure I'm not taken down. Can't believe it. Did it. Finally. What felt like longer than 56 minutes. Did not feel like 56 minutes. It felt longer.
not even going to. Entertain his power being active. Good. I'll just end turn there. One. I don't care. I'm defeating this mission now. Boom.
Impossible! There's no way you could have destroyed my death ray. Awesome spirit. Andy, run away!
Andy!
Okay, we are getting cutscene.
Chance is a fickle thing. You never know when it will come your way. And yet, here it is.
Hey! That's Hawk!
Sturm, I think it is time you were relieved of your command.
Hawk! Black Sturm! You traitor!
Good riddance.
But why? Why would you?
Interesting way to perceive Black Storm.
Lord Sturm is no more.
Wait, did they add a... That's a lot of that is new dialogue.
Ha ha!
Bask in the presence of our indomitable greatness.
That could have been better, but hey, I'm not complaining. And with that, it is the end of an era. Another LP done. So, with the Black Hole Army driven from its shores, Macroland was free at last. But peace is a fragile thing. Stay vigilant until next time. We could skip this. Oh, I didn't skip it, apparently. So, with that, Oh no. Well, time for my final thoughts, and I'm conflicted, because while I enjoyed Advance Wars, Reboot Camp, there were definitely things that, like, felt harder. Some things felt off, but maybe the dialogue changes. Dialogue changes, I think some of them, most of them were fine, but some were something awkward. Like, changing what Sonya calls Sturm before finding out his name. Changing to that creepy guy from the disaster is a... But despite my raid times, because most of my rage was from them just remaking the game. Because most of it was just remakes, taking away glitches, adding in stuff. I had fun. So, what is going to come next? Well, in the middle of this LP, Xenoblade 3, Pre's DLC finally came out, the last bit of it, the story DLC. So I'll be playing that while you guys are enjoying this, and hopefully, if I haven't gone swept up in Xenoblade 3, I'll be doing the Commander's Challenge, which is my own little pet project. But this isn't the end for Advance Wars. I am planning on doing an advanced campaign version of 2, not 1. I may do 1 in my own time, but 1's very rough, so I don't think I will ever do an LP of advanced campaign of 1. And your thoughts? If any update were to happen that have a major effect, I would ask WaveWorld to change design of the tanks or the medium tanks to be much more obvious, because at a glance I'm still confusing them. My personal grievance with Aaron Hansen aside, I don't think I have a complaint about the voice actors, and I hope they get the chance to effectively either remake Dual Strike or make their own sequel. If they do make their own sequel, I hope they make a non-canon version of Sturm be playable, and not do Dual Strike and introduce the terrible Von Bolt. A rank. Better than I would have thought. But I've already got it all. I will eventually. Where to beat challenge campaign to get Hachi to?
Well, I'll be. Hey there. How you taste? You all look.
Oh, hey, finally. Oh my god, this. Okay, I need to see this before. Okay, so first of all, battle maps, Badlands, okay, seals. There's even a fucking hero. By Sturm? Yes, because I want to see the extra pieces. And I will eventually pay for all these. But I'll be first getting all the CEOs, including Hachi.
Knock 'em down out there for Hachi, okay?
Will they change? Nope. Sturm enlisted. Well, let's quickly check out what extra things they've put into the design room. Yeah, these are some of the maps. Capture test isn't. It's just me remaking an old map. Escort problem, I'm going to be fixing because there's some problems that I don't like. But this is going to be one of the ones we're doing in Clash City. Definitely. But I want to see, because if I've got new stuff, then I really want to see. Yes! Oh, this is something a lot of people wanted. Oh, I really like this. This will help with the Commander's Challenge. By the time you guys see this, I will probably make some of these new mission maps that I'm going to enjoy. Yeah, there's nothing else to add. I have so many ideas to do with this dev ray. You can't even turn it, sadly, but I have ideas. Let's see if we can turn this. Oops. Okay, so you can't edit the dev ray. Slightly sad. Let's see. Okay, we can edit that. That's actually clever. Can't edit that. Too bad we don't have a lab. Oh, we can only have the volcano or the dev ray.
Interesting. Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna be playing around with this. Oh, I'm a little bit sad we don't camp the factory though, because now that is something I would want to play with. But yeah, next time on this channel, it's Let's Play Xenoblade 3. See you guys then. Xeno and Zuma, signing out.